Skywatch Media News for December the 5th, 2019. At the furthest edge of the Earth's polar regions, something very strange and unexplained is taking place. What's happening near the poles in an area known as the Cusp is having a profound effect on modern technology, including satellite connections, GPS systems, and gadgets that use radio waves. Over the years, we have heard many stories about how our magnetic field is weakening, allowing the magnetic North Pole to migrate away from Canada and towards the east at a rapid pace, while at the same time creating magnetic anomalies in the South Atlantic, both occurrences of which satellite data has shown to be accurate. Whether the weakening of the field will result in a magnetic pole shift much sooner than anticipated is still unknown, but here is something we do know that may provide a glimpse into what is presently occurring with the Earth's poles. With each second that passes, 1.5 million tons of solar particles shoot off of the sun and into space, traveling at hundreds of miles per second. This continual stream of plasma is known as the solar wind, which has pelted the Earth since the time of its creation. Because our planet has been gifted with a strong magnetic field, most of these harmful particles have been deflected away, with one exception, that being the furthest reaches of the poles, those cusp or cleft-shaped formations at opposite ends of our world. Within this region, close to the Earth's poles, the magnetic field becomes a funnel where the solar wind can reach our atmosphere, and this is where the trouble exists. This influx of particles disrupts the atmosphere, causing satellite, GPS, and radio signals to go haywire. The recent disruptions has become such a problem that NASA has initiated a series of missions into the northern polar cusp, hoping to improve the technology that has been affected by this strange phenomenon. They're calling this the Grand Challenge Initiative. So it seems that the importance of this series of missions cannot be underestimated. A total of 9 rockets, each of them similar to space vehicles 65 feet in height, will be launched anywhere from 20 to 800 miles into the atmosphere to record the sounds originating from this strange phenomenon located inside of the polar cusp. In particular, they are looking at a patch of atmosphere that is much denser than its surroundings. Back in the year 2004, scientists had discovered that part of the atmosphere inside of the cusp was 1.5 times more dense than expected. Now, the discovery is notable because any pressure change associated with the increased mass density that is occurring at 200 miles above the surface of the Earth may not seem that alarming. But if this increase in density occurred at ground level, it would have the capability of creating a perpetual hurricane, a hurricane much stronger than anything ever recorded on the face of the Earth. Therefore, the polar phenomenon has the capability of shaking up satellite trajectories while creating problems for spacecraft that fly through this dense patch that is located in the polar cusp. The unusual patch of dense atmosphere needs to be thoroughly investigated in order to evaluate its effectiveness on any satellites that pass through its boundaries. It's not just spacecraft that react unpredictably near the cusp, so does the GPS and its transmitted communication signals. The atmospheric turbulence brought on by this mysterious anomaly is a big concern for the mission investigators, because as the atmosphere grows turbulent, the GPS and communication signals passing close to the cusp become garbled, therefore sending unreliable signals to aircraft and ships that depend on these signals for safe navigation. Therefore, the integrity of GPS signals is of the utmost importance in today's society. The loss of such communications would be inconceivable. The launch of the rockets from the extreme north provides a pristine location for examining this phenomenon. Therefore, the small Arctic region of Svalbard on the Norwegian archipelago was chosen for this mission, due in part to its small population, but also because of its strict use of radio and Wi-Fi communications. Coincidentally, Svalbard, the chosen site for the Polar Cusp mission, is also known as the home of the Global Seed and Data Preservation Vaults, the exact location of which is kept secret from the general public. When NASA launched their sounding rocket from Svalbard on November the 26th as part of their Grand Challenge mission, their hope was that they could determine the cause of the cusp irregularities. Unfortunately for them, but most importantly for the world, it was revealed that the mission did not perform as planned, and scientists are now left wondering what might have gone wrong. The last mission in this current group of rocket launches is the investigation into measuring the flow of plasma and gases within the cusp, how they heat up, how they accelerate, and how they interact with each other. All of the measuring and the collection of important data is meant to help scientists better understand what is happening in our upper atmosphere. But it is also important that they understand what they may be dealing with, and how they may predict the behavior of the cusp in our future. Now, it's understandable at times to criticize scientists, especially when their work seems to be incomplete and inconclusive. And this may explain why they planned a series of rockets to explore the far reaches of the polar regions. If one mission fails, another one may provide some of the crucial answers necessary if we are going to avoid the serious interference that they now say is happening with our lower orbit and our Earth technology systems. If we can't trust our scientists for answers, then who can we trust? What's happening to the polar cusp is no different than what is happening here on Earth. Our planet and our atmosphere are in the process of changing. All we can do as observers is to ask for knowledge and guidance so that we can better prepare for the changes that we face. This is the one gift that each of us inherits, the freedom of choice. The one question that remains is whether we will choose wisely or choose in haste. Over the years, there is one great gift that has stood out above all the others that I have received in my life's journey, and that is the gift of giving. It is a gift which each of us cherishes during this joyous time of the year. But we should also be mindful that the gift of giving is something that should be part of our life throughout the year, rather than when it becomes convenient. I learned that lesson long ago, and it has changed my life for the better. My devotion lies with these video productions, primarily because it allows me to share my knowledge and my life's experiences with each of you who have shown an interest in following this channel. In a way, it is my gift to you, and it has brought great pleasure and satisfaction knowing that many of you have given through your generous comments. This is how each of us can come together. This is how each of us can make a difference in this complex and often troubling world. Service to others is a great endeavor. Sometimes it can be challenging, but often it is rewarding. And so I look forward to our time together, making our moments a little more meaningful and a little more substantive. Thanks for watching.